just thinking there, we just never know who's going to start first. Jules here, in the jungle, in Cranchise Kitchen. What is on the menu today, darling?
Kai tiao mu sap.
Yes. To the rest of us, that is a straightforward Thai omelette. But it's rather special, actually, rather special. You can make them with pork or chicken. What have we got today?
Chopped pork.
Now, we have a separate video to show you how to prepare chopped pork Thai style. So, the other things in this, it's very simple to say, but you should have printed off your recipe already. Chopped spring onions, okay, chopped spring onions, or scallions, and shallots, nicely chopped, red shallots if you can get them, but not to worry if you can't. Penny thickness sort of thing, and a couple of eggs. easy. But it's quite surprising the way she actually makes it. I was surprised first time I saw it. Now, you have this, don't you,
with spicy food.
So you can have it as an omelette on its own, but more often than not, it's just chucked on the table as an extra with something spicy, or even as a, you know, with a soup to sort of fill it out a bit. So,
yeah.
What's first, darling?
Mix everything together first.
Okay, great.
Well, we assume you know how to break eggs, so we've done that bit. Now, the reason we're doing this recipe, which is quite a very simple one really, is because it forms the basis of quite a few others to come.
Next.
Okay. Then, so just mix it all in raw. I was surprised, I thought you might cook the pork first. But obviously
chicken.
Not. Bit of chicken stock.
Seasoning sauce.
Splurge of seasoning sauce. So she's used about half of a tablespoon of seasoning sauce. A bit more maybe. She started with a tablespoon anyway. So there's your mix.
Yes. Okay. Cook it.
Right. Let's get it on the cooker.
Yes.
Okay. Scorching hot wok. As hot as you can get it. So it's smoking a bit.
Okay.
You know it's ready like that. Now, you do this with 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil in the wok, which is, I was never taught to do it with oil like that in the Navy. We used to get the wok oily and then pour it out. So there's quite a lot of oil in there, and it makes for a nice fluffy omelette. So swudge it down a bit.
First time you see Thai omelette, you surprised.
Yeah, very surprised first time I saw it. Yeah, with all the oil. But also they're very fluffy. I think I mentioned it when we did the pork stuffed omelette, that was just a plain omelette, which the amount of oil you use is really quite surprising. Now, are you going to flip it, darling?
Yes, that's normal.
How are you going to flip it?
No, cannot do same before, Cha. Because you...
Oh, go on, have a go. She usually just flips
it. You want
them
to see it?
Yeah, go on, do it. We'll shoot the video again if it goes wrong. There you go, that's how you do it.
Yes.
I knew she could do it, of course. So there we go, and then we cook the other side. And you sort of worry, or I did anyway, first time, is the meat going to be cooked in there? But it is.
Yeah, okay.
As long as you chop it up finely enough.
If customer want to do same, you have to be careful in the jar oil.
Yes, yeah, because there is quite a bit of oil in there. You've got to be careful if you want to flip it that style, because it will splash back. As you can see, maybe on this side of the pan, some of the egg came back.
Yeah.
It will splash the oil back at you. So be careful. She's using quite a deep or steep-sided wok there. Good old faithful non-stick wok, which is getting less and less non-stick the more we use it with metal implements.
Good smell.
Does smell nice, yeah. Savoury egg smell.
Jintan Le.
Sounds like next door's got a disco going. Which makes a change from them being drunk. Oh, look at that, he's lovely. Are we nearly done?
Yeah, nearly done.
Yeah. So, this is real timing, I'm not editing anything out. Makes a boring video though, doesn't it?
Easy and delicious.
It is. So the next recipe we're going to do, which actually uses this style of omelette.
Bouillabaisse.
What's it called, Jar? The one with the soup, with omelette soup, isn't it?
Yes, kai nam.
Kai nam, there you go. So that's the next video we're going to do.
Okay, then.
Okay.
Done.
Yes, as you can see, Madam has taken a chunk out of my omelette. See, off the sides, she's already munching. Poor girl, starving. Right, now we've got a lovely, lovely omelette here, which is often, I have this for lunch, because I'm a bit of a fatty these days. So it's just a nice, good for you, healthy omelette.
This children can do
all that. Oh, the flavours in that are superb. You've just got to, and it's soft and fluffy. Come on. Beautiful. Now, the other thing, if you're having it just as a snack, because obviously this is something at the outset we said, you stick it on the table when you've got curries and stuff. There's, over here you can get, I don't know if you can get it where you are, it's Heinz tomato ketchup, but chili style. Mm. So we'll have a little dab of that as well. Chili sauce, basically, any chili sauce on it. And
too hungry.
Oh, I am hungry, actually. Mm.
Not eat yet this morning.
Chicken. So you can have a spicy omelette and a bit of side salad to garnish it. You've got a lovely lunch. Easy, isn't it?
Yeah. If you're hungry, okay.
Are you going to say goodbye?
Yes.
Yes, it's a chili house, so thank you for joining us.